Keep below, keep your cabin, should you assist the storm.
Okay, good, be patient.
When the sea is hence.
Remember whom thou hast aboard.
What cares for the wars of the name of king? Down with the topmast, yaw, lower, lower.
A pipe's not you throat, you fallen, blasphemous, enchantable dog.
Work you then.
Hanko, hang, we are less afraid to be drowned than thou art.
Mercy on us, we split.
We split.
My dearest father, you've put these wild waters in this raw, allay them.
There's no harm done.
Oh, woe the day.
No harm. I've done nothing but take care of thee, my daughter, who art ignorant of what thou art. It's time I should inform thee, father. Lend thy hand and pluck thy magic garment from me. Lie there, my lord. Canst thou remember a time before we came unto the cell? I do not think thou canst, but thou was not out 3 years old.
'Tis far off and rather like a dream.
12 years since, Miranda, 12 years since. Thy father was a Duke of Milan and a Prince of Power.
Oh, the heavens! What foul play have we that we came from then?
My brother and thy uncle, called Antonio, he did believe he was indeed the Duke. Dost thou hear?
Your tale, sir, could cure deafness.
The King of Naples, being an enemy to me in Vertrade, hearkens thine his brother's suit, whereon one midnight a treacherous army levied, and outside it the gates of Milan, hurried thence me and thy crying self.
And lack for pity, wherefore did they not bear our destroyer?
Dear, they durst not. So dear the love they bore us that they bore us in leagues to the sea. They prepared the rotten carcass of a butt, not rigged, that the very rats instinctively had quitted.
How came we ashore?
By providence divine, some food we had and some fresh water that a noble Neapolitan Lazzaro did give us, with rich garments, linens, stuffs, and accessories. Knowing I love my books, he furnished me with volumes that I prize above my dukedom.
But I might ever see that man. And now I pray you, sir, your reason for raising this sea storm.
No, thus far forth. By an accident most strange, bountiful, have my enemies been brought to the shore. Here cease more questions. Thou art inclined to see. Approach my Ariel, come!
Oh, hail, great master!
Hast thou spirit performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
To every article, all but marine is plunged in a foam and brine, and quit the vessel.
Why, that's my spirit, but are they, my Ariel, safe?
Not a hair perish. Their garments fresher than before. In troops I have dispersed them about the isle. The king's son, I've landed by himself, whom I left sitting his arms in this sad knot.
Of the king's ship?
Safely in harbour. The mariners are under hatches, stowed. I have left asleep.
Ariel, by his charge, exactly as performed. But there is more work.
Is there more toil? Let me remember what thee hast promised, my liberty.
Before the time be out, no more.
I pray thee, remember, I've done thee worthy service.
Hast thou forgot the foul Sycorax? Thou best knowest what torment I did find thee in.
I thank you, master.
After 2 days, I will discharge thee.
What shall I do? Say what? What shall I do?
Go make thyself like a nymph of the sea, invisible. Awake, dear heart, awake. Thou slept well.
Strangest of your stories put heaviness on me.
We'll go visit Caliban, my slave, who never yields his kind answer.
Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look upon.
But as tis, we cannot miss him. He does make our fire. What ho, slave, Caliban!
There's wood enough within.
Come forth, I say! Ah, fine apparition, my quaint Ariel. How can I hear?
My lord, it shall be done.
I must eat my dinner. This all was mine by Sycorax, my mother. And thou camest and took it from me when thou camest first. Thou strokest me and makest much of me, and I love thee. And I showed thee all the qualities of this isle. Damn it me that I did so. And let all lights of all the curses upon you, toads and beetles and bats light upon you, for you stymie on this hard rock.
Thou liest, slave! I have used thee, filth as thou art, with human care, till thou didst seek to violate the honour of my child.
Oh, ho, I would not have done if thou didn't prevent me. This arm was Caliban's.
Hagged him hence, fetched and fuel. Shockst thou?
I pray thee, I must obey. His art is of such power.
So slave hence.
For 5 and 5, my father lies. Of his bones are coral made. Those are pearls that were his eyes. nothing of him that doth fade, but doth suffer a sea change into something rich and strange. See nymphs hourly ring his knell. Hark now, I hear them. Hark now, I hear them. Din dun bell, din dun, din dun bell.
The ditty does remember my drowned father. This is no mortal business.
Nor how it looks about. It carries a strange form. What is it, a spirit?
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and has such senses as we have. This gallant which thou seest was in the rack. He hath lost his fellows, and he seeks about to find them.
Might call him a thing divine.
Oh, my sure goddess on who the aims attend. My prime request is, oh, you wonder if you be made or not.
No wonder, sir, but certainly you're made.
Oh, heavens, my language! Oh, if you be a virgin, and your affection not gone forth, I'll make you queen of Naples.
Soft, sir, one word more. They're both in either's palace, but this swift business I must uneasy make, lest two lights make the prize winning light. Thou hast put thyself upon this island as a spy, to win it from me, the Lord Arnold.
No, as I'm a man.
There's nothing ill can dwell in such a temple.
Follow me. Speak not for you as a traitor. Come.
Oh, dear father!
Come on, obey.
The weakness that my father's lost. I've lost all my friends. Oh, I prithee, let me see this fair maid one day, for one day.
Thou hast done well, Finero.
I beseech you, sir, be merry, for our escape is much beyond our loss.
Prithee, peace.
Who receives comfort like cold porridge?
My son is lost. I near again shall see him, although mine heir of Naples and Milan. What strange fish have made his mourn thee?
I am very heavy.
Wondrous heavy.
What strange drowsiness possesses them?
It's the quality of climate.
Why doth it not that not eyelids sink? Find not myself, despised to sleep.
Nor I. They dropped as thy thunder stroke. What might, worthy Sebastian? Oh, what might? No more. And yet methinks I see it in thy face. My strong imagination sees a crown dropping upon thy head.
What art thou awake?
Do you not hear me speak?
I do. Shall I let thy sleep?
Thou lets thy fortune sleep.
Die rather. Thou dost snore distinctly. There's meaning in thy snores.
Noble Sebastian, will you grant with me? His son Ferdinand is drowned.
He's gone.
And what is this sleep to your advancement? Do you understand me?
Methinks I do. You did supplant your brother Prospero.
True. And look how well my guardament sits upon me. Here lies your brother, no better than the earth he lies upon.
Shall be my present as thou gotst Milan. Come by Naples, draw thy sword.
Draw together, and while I rear my hand, you do the like. To fall, it's on Gonzalo.
Why, how now? Why are you drawn?
We had a hollow burst of bone, like balls or rather lions. Did it not wake you? It struck mine ear most terribly.
Did you hear of this, Gonzalo?
Aye, a faint humming, which did awake me.
Lead off this ground and let's search more for my poor son.
Oh heavens, keep him from these beasts.
Lead away.
Prosper, my lord, shall know what I've done. So can go safely on to seek thy son.
Infection, blood sucks up, bogs, bends and fat. A prosper fool, make him by inch meal a disease. Lo now, here comes the spirit of his torment me for bringing my wood in slowly.
What have we here? A man? A fish? Dead or alive? Oh, a fish! He smells like a fish! A very ancient fish-like smell. Leg like a man? Fin-like arms? Well, my if my trot, for this is no fish but an islander that hath lately suffered by thunderbolt. Alas, the storm has come again. My best way to hide under his garb and die.
let me, spirit. I'll bring my wood home faster.
This is some monster of the isle with... one, two, three, four legs. And where the devil should he learn our language?
Do not torment me. The spirit torments me.
He is in his fit now and does not talk after the wisest. Open your mouth. This will shake your shaking, I do assure thee.
I should know that voice, but for he's drowned.
Four legs and two voices. A most delicate monster. I shall pour some into the other mouth.
Stefano!
Mercy, mercy!
If thou be Stefano, it's thy Trinculo. Be not afeard, thy good friend Trinculo.
If thou beest Trinculo, come forth.
Oh, I'm not drowned! Oh, I tell I'm not drowned!
Oh, prithee, do not turn me about, for my stomach is not constant.
That's a brave god. I bear celestial liquor. I will kneel to him.
Stefano, hast any more of this?
The whole Batman.
Hast thou fallen from heaven?
Out of the moon, I do assure thee.
I prithee, be my god. A plague upon the tyrant I serve, and I will bear him no more sticks, but follow you, thou wondrous man.
How can a wife of dick and monster make a wonder of poor drunkards?
Trinculo, the king and all of our company else drowned. We will inherit here. Here, by my bottle.
Bad, bad, come back!
Oh, brave monster, lead the way!
As any master can be man.
Please, if you'll sit down, I'll bear your locks along.
No, precious creature. I'd rather crack my sinews and break thy back.
Pray give me that, I'll carry it.
No, noble mistress. 'Tis fresh morning when you are about.
Poor one, thou art infected.
You look wearily.
No. I do beseech you. What's your name?
Miranda.
Oh, I admired Miranda.
I've not wished any companion in the world but you.
I am, in my condition, a prince, Miranda. I would not be so a king. Hear my heart speak, for there it resides, and for your sake I'm this patient log man.
Do you love me?
Aye, beyond all limit.
Wherefore to weep at what I am glad of?
Wherefore weep you?
At mine unworthiness. I am your wife if you will marry me, but if not, then I will die your maid.
I am my wife.
My husband, then?
I.
And here's my hand with my heart in it. And now farewell until half an hour hence.
A thousand.
The fair encounter of too much rare affections.
As I said, I'm subject to a tyrant, a sorcerer who hath by his cunning cheated me of the isle.
Thou liest?
Thou jesting monkey, thou. My valued master will destroy thee, I do not lie.
Trinculo, trouble him any more in his tale, and by this hand I will supplement some of your tea.
I did nothing.
Mum, then, no more. Proceed.
I say by sorcery he got this isle, and from me he got it. I yield him the asleep, and... there we must knock a nail into his head.
Thou liest, thou cannot.
What a pining is this, thou scurvy patch?
Trinculo, interrupt the monster one word further, and by this hand I will make a stockfish out of thee.
Why? What did I? I did nothing.
Didst thou not say he lied?
Thou liest.
Do I so? Well, take thou that. As you like it, give me the lie another time.
I did not lie.
Prithee, stand farther off. Stand, father.
Proceed.
shall be asleep within the next half hour. Will this we destroy him then?
Aye, on my honour.
Excellent.
This I will tell my master.
Mercy upon us!
Art thou afeard?
No, monster. Not I.
Do not be afeard. This isle is full of sounds and sweet airs that mean good and not harm. A thousand instruments and sometimes voices will hum in mine ears. If I had just recently woken from sleep, they would send me to sleep yet again.
This will prove a brave kingdom to me. Please, monster.
You are three men of sin. From a land is a plant could prospero, exposing to the sea. Him and his innocent child, for which foul deed. The powers and sense of seas and shores against your peace. Leave my son, Alonso. They have profit and do pronounce by me. Link grim prediction, worse than any death.
Bravely the figure of this harpy has thou performed. My Ariel, they are now in my power.
In the name of something holy, sir, why stand you in the strange stair?
Oh, it is monstrous, monstrous, methought the bellow spoke, pronounced between my trespass. Therefore my son Ithus is bedded. I'll seek him deep than ear plummet sounded, and with him there lie mudded.
If I have too austerely punished you, my compensation makes amends. Thou hast strangely stood the test, O Ferdinand. Thou shalt find she will outstrip all praise.
I do believe it.
Sit then and talk with her. She is thine own. What, Ariel, my industrious servant?
What of my pretend master?
Go bring the rabble over whom I give thee power, for I must show this young couple some vanity of mine art.
Before you can say come and go, each one tripping on his toe, we'll come here with mop and mow. Do you love me, master? No?
Deal in my delicate Ariel.
Come temperate nymphs, and celebrate a contract of true love, be not too late.
I forgot the foul plan and conspiracy against me with Caliban, his beasts.
Well done, no more. This is strange. Your father's in some passion that does not work in kindly.
Never till this day saw I him so touched with anger, so distempered.
Our revels now ended. These are spirits, as I have foretold you, our actors are all spirits, and as such are melted into air, into thin air. We are such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little life is rounded with the sleep. Sir, I am vexed. A tunnel to a walk to still my beating mind.
We wish you peace.
Ariel, please.
What's thy pleasure?
It's time to catch Caliban and his confederates.
Oh, aye, my commander.
Go bring the trumpery in my house for stale to catch these thieves.
I go.
This is the mouth of the cell. No noise, and enter.
Oh, King Sephon, look! A wardrobe here is for thee!
Oh, let us alone, thou fools. Tis but trash.
Ha ha! I pierce Stefano.
Just let us alone. Do the murder first.
Monster, help to bear this away, or I'll turn you out of my kingdom. Go to, carry this.
Let them be hunted soundly, now does my project gather to a head. Say, Ariel, how fares the king's and followers?
Just as you left them all prisoners, sir, they will not budge till your release. Your charm so strongly works them, that if you beheld them, your affections would become tender.
Dost thou think so, spirit?
Mine would, sir, where are human?
Art thou, which art but air, touch a feeling, be kindly and move them one of their own kind? Go release them, Ariel.
I'll fetch them, sir.
Ye elves of hills, brooks, standing lakes and groves, I have, though weak ye masters be, I've wixt the green sea and twixt the azured vault. This roaring war, this rough magic I here abjure. I'll break my staff, bear it certain fathoms from the earth. And deeper than did ever plummet sound, I'll drown my book. The rarer action is in virtue than in vengeance. They being pertinent, the sole drift of my purpose doth not extend a frown further.